One World Radio.
So listen, I'm telling you, we do things in big ways here at One World Radio. We do things differently here at Tomorrowland. And when you get Steve Angello in the building, you turn down the music and you listen to what the man has to say. So Steve Angello in the house. Whoop, whoop. Come on, make some noise, Mr. Everyone's got their cameras out. Everyone's too busy filming what you've got to say.
We have a crowd and all, you know? We have a crowd and all.
You can't clap with one hand.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah. I'm like...
Steve Angello in the house. Now, to be clear, this interview will not last as long as the one we did at Tomorrowland Winter, because otherwise I'll get told off. Mate, that was an amazing chat with so much detail, and it just highlighted how busy you have been. So, all of that work that you've been doing, you're about to land it here across two weekends, right?
Yes, yes.
So where do we start? Because the main stage, then a back-to-back with Seb, then a Freedom Stage takeover to celebrate size 20.
Yes.
Where do we start?
Start with today, I think, right?
So what's going to happen today?
We'll see, you know. It depends on the vibe. You know, the crowd's always great here. We have a thing going. So I'm waiting for the sun to set. You know, I'm going to walk on the second it hits the horizon.
That means you're going to be bringing some dark energy to the...
Yes, definitely.
Right, Steve Angello, when the night's in, is an exciting prospect.
Yes.
So, I'm going to have to pull this out of you, aren't I? Present day music, let's start with The Who and your absolute slammer with that. Talk to us, how did that collaboration come about?
I mean, we've talked about it for a while, you know, and then, you know, they sent me a snippet of a sample play, and then we were like, okay, let's do it. You know, we finished the record 6-7 months ago, but we were waiting on size 20 celebrations to kick off, you know, so it was nice. We've been waiting, and I waited for the summer. It's a summer song, so I wanted the heat to help the record, you know.
It's already been Tune of the Week here on One World Radio, but what was your reference point from that sample? Was it Mantronics or Strings?
All the old ones, yeah. I mean, it's been used a couple of times, you know, so it dates back to 96, 99, 2004, you know, so it's
encyclopedic knowledge of everything that's been released.
It's called old.
Okay, you told me at Tomorrowland Winter that by now that you had so much music and it was finished, right? So
Omen is coming tonight. We're playing it.
I love it.
Omen's played. I have a lot of. I think 60% of the set is probably unheard and unreleased.
Okay, just to clarify, that's a lot of IDs, everybody. So you're not sharing, so I'm going to have to pull them out of you. I love it. He's good at this, you know. So if we're not talking about... If by now you've ticked that box, we've got to talk about the Swedes, all right? Because you've obviously been releasing lots of new music. See the Light. Again, just a massive
beautiful
tune. Talk to us.
Yeah, it's one of those moment records, you know. It's like we made that record entirely for ourselves. We had a moment one night in we were actually in an ABBA studio, and we started playing around with the chords and the melodies and that vocal sample, and we found this beautiful phone recording from Friday, the artist, that it was a message to his mom. So we sampled his phone message basically and made a song out of it, and it's a really beautiful, the meaning behind it is beautiful.
So because everyone's asking me to ask about Ray of Solar.
Couple of weeks. I'm ending with it tonight.
I love. Yeah. This is the best news ever.
So that's coming out in a couple of weeks.
All right. Because you're making me do the legwork here. So what about Steve Angello? What about size? Where's the connection? What's coming?
There's a lot coming. You know, I think we have one release a week now till March.
So give me some. As a Tomorrowland treat, just give us some of the details. Come on, just a few.
What You Need was released today.
Which is, Friday.
Friday, right, yeah. So we're going to have a size Friday, basically. We're going to have one release a week. So I have remade all the old Steve Angello records. I've remixed... all the big size records, everything from Atom to Voices.
So sexy, sexy.
Yeah, Sexy Bleep is remixed. I mean, all those old records, like all of them, you know. So it's a nice way to celebrate, you know. I've done this for a while, and it's a nice celebration to a new generation of music lovers to like get all this music again, because music gets lost.
You know, everyone here is here to see you tonight. I've already asked everybody.
Are you going to main stage or?
Who here is going to see Steve Angello tonight on the main stage?
You're coming. Okay, there you go.
I already asked. Yeah. I already knew that was going to be the response. But then you've got back-to-back with Sebastian Ingrosso. That's going to be amazing.
Yeah.
That's
going
to be so exciting.
Next week, Friday, right?
Yeah, and then obviously you're taking over the stage. It's going to be so exciting. Let's just talk about Tomorrowland now.
Yeah, yeah,
okay.
Sure.
Okay. Last time you were here, 2018,
18 or 19, 18. Just before the pandemic, right?
Yeah. Yeah. So what's different from now? What's different about you? What's different about the festival?
A lot. You know, it's a different me, you know, in a good way. You know, I'm always going to be the same, but it's like there's a lot of stuff happening right now musically that's super exciting. So it's just nice to come in. You know, most people that come here, they play the big records because it's a busy stage and it's a lot of people, they usually think it's just a mainstream crowd, right? So they just want to play all the hits. But for me, it's always the perfect crowd to try new music because that's the most critical, right? So I always come here as an experiment.
Do you know what? I hope this is being conveyed in the interview and that everyone listening at home can hear. I'm sensing danger right now. This is Steve Danger, Angello.
Yes.
Right. There's a lot of danger in you now.
Yeah, there's a lot of energy here.
Yeah.
So,
It's exciting. I mean, usually everyone's looking towards new artists or what they bring in. I'm sensing this is like you kind of times 10 or times 20 to me.
100%. 100%.
Watch out, world. All right. Watch out, world. Let me catch then. It'd be rude not to. I know that we're looking very much on the horizon at this Tomorrowland. Yeah. But do you have a favorite Tomorrowland memory? And what is it? It could be from any year, what is it?
Oh, that's tricky. I've played here since, 2006?
There's a lot of memories.
2007, yeah, there's a lot of memories. But I think we did a daytime show once, Swedish House Mafia show. That was one of my favorite moments.
Do you mind if I ask why? What do you recall from that moment?
It was just the first time I realized how big it is. You know, it's like, sometimes, like when life passes, when you run really fast, like we do, we run fast all the time, right? So you don't kind of think and look back and like let things digest, you know? So for me, it was like one of those moments. I walked around the festival and I was like, okay, this is different, you know? This is massive. So, I mean, look at what they've created, you know? And it's great. It's beautiful, you know, to see. It's about the unity and the people in the end, you know, and the loyalty that Tomorrowland had brought with the fans and built this, like, personal connection. It's a really beautiful thing to see, and more people should see it.
I'm sorry that we're talking for so long, but I kind of don't
care.
Right. Listen, have you seen the Tomorrowland main stage, where you're going?
I'm going to go now. I saw pictures of it.
You are going to be so close to the people of tomorrow. It's going to be amazing.
Okay, great.
But I also now want to look forward, just in case I don't get to speak to you again. Tomorrow,
I can swing by after.
Good, perfect. I'm going to hold you to that. Tomorrowland Brazil is coming.
Yes, and that's a massive one.
I know.
I haven't been in Brazil in a second, right? So that's a big one. We teased it last time I saw you.
Now we can say
now
what
we
it
can
is.
Talk about it. Yeah, I mean, to play in South America for us has always been amazing. So the crowd there is so much passion and energy and love. And, you know, the things they go through right now with, like, you know, politics and economy and everything that goes around, like everything, all of that is out the window when we show up and play music, and just the energy there, it's beautiful.
Watch out, Brazil. Steve's coming in.
Yes.
And he's not messing around.
No, I'm coming. I'm coming in hot.
I'm excited. I want you to just for one final question, I want you to delve into this pop.
Someone else can pick it.
Okay, it's got here we go. Stay there, Steve.
Yep.
Tell the world about the next idea that you want to tell us. You have to answer that question.
How do you approach building a connection with your audience during a DJ set?
No way.
I mean, I think here's the thing. I feed off the energy of the crowd, right? I like to play at this time because I can actually connect with the crowd. Eye contact before I perform because I get a much nicer energy boost out of that. So for me, it's about just having that play with the crowd. I find people in the crowd all the time that I, you know, I hang on to for a second, you know, and I play for them, you know.
You're in sync with your audience.
Yes, 100%.
I love that.
So if I get the energy, I'll bring the energy.
You know what to do, people of tomorrow. Give the energy to Steve Angello. Give it him right now. Come on, round of applause. Come on. Love you, man.
Thank you all.
You have to come back, all right?
Yes, I'll come.
There's much more to talk about.